tropical entomologist at Wageningen University in the Netherlands. Since about 1.5 years, I'm retired, so I'm emeritus professor right now. So I have more time to dedicate myself to edible insects. But I used to be, responsible for a number of projects in the tropics on integrated pest management and biological control. But since, 20 years, I started to work on edible insects. The main reason is that, agricultural land which is used for livestock is about 75%. But if you look at the demand for meat, that will increase also by 70-80%. So it means that the amount of land available to produce that meat in future is not enough. So we need alternative protein sources. Then if you look at livestock is responsible for, 70% of all greenhouse gas emissions. It's responsible for more than 14%, of the greenhouse gas emissions and for 60-70% of the ammonia emissions. There are a lot of other problems associated with the livestock production. Deforestation, pollution, you name it. So that is why I think we need alternative protein sources. And insects are a very good one because they have a number of advantages. If you look at the energy used, it's more or less similar. But if you look at, greenhouse gas emissions, if you look at ammonia emissions, if you look at land area that is needed to produce those insects, and if you look at the water requirements for those insects, then it's much less than livestock production. And there is another very big advantage of the insects is that you can grow them on organic byproducts. First of all, you look at if you look at, the insect currently that are eaten, they are all harvested from nature. But if we want to promote it, you cannot continue harvesting from nature. And there are already examples of over-exploitation. So the only way in order to produce enough insects, that's to rear them. And to rear them, that has to be on a large scale. Of course, it can be done small scale, as is done in Thailand. There are about 20,000 different farms that produce small scale crickets. But if we think about using insects for poultry and for pigs, then we need huge amounts of insects. And that can only be done if you do that in large automated facilities, almost factories. And there are currently, over the world, there are several companies that are developing those rearing facilities. And they can produce, tons a day. And that's absolutely necessary. And if you look at the market, first of all, for agriculture, half of the fish that we eat currently has been farmed, is cultured. We used always fish meal, but fish meal is getting too expensive. It's becoming scarce, so we need alternatives. And you can use, of course, plant-derived products, but those have a number of disadvantages, while insects are a very good replacement. There are quite some articles that appeared very recently on consumer attitudes. If I just look at the Netherlands, when I started about 20 years ago, hardly anybody knew that you could eat insects. And also, when I asked to the audience how many people have eaten insects, then just a few hands went up. When I now give a lecture in the Netherlands, then everybody knows that you can eat insects. And if he asked them, how many of you have eaten insects, then half of the hands go up already. So I think a lot is changing in the last few years. And if you even look in the Netherlands, there is one supermarket chain, but also another one, that has already insect products in the market. So you can buy burgers made from insects, and you can buy them all over the Netherlands. So that is already quite an achievement. And I think the strategies that you have to use is, first of all, put the insects in products that people know, like nuggets or burgers or schnitzels or meatballs, those kind of things. So make it, use the familiar products, so people don't get scared by seeing an insect. The other one is giving people a taste experience. So there are a lot of events in which, let's say, insects are produced and given during food fairs and all those kind of things to people. And when you have tasted it once, then the second time is no problem anymore. And the other one is, well, you can use role models. We interviewed for our cookbook, we interviewed Kofi Annan, for example. Kofi Annan indicated, well, it's just a matter of educating the public.